Emily, thank you so much for having me over. I've really been looking forward to meeting you.
I've been looking forward to meeting you too. I'm so glad you can come, Lisa. I'm feeling a little nervous. I hope I qualify to help out somewhere at church.
Of course you do. There's a place for everyone to serve. That's the purpose of our meeting, to find a fit that's perfect for you. So, let's get started. Shall we start with prayer? Lord, you have gifted Emily in special ways to shine for you. Please be with us as we explore her talents and ways that you might use them. Amen.
Amen.
Do you have your copy of my gift portrait?
Yes.
So, tell me a little bit about yourself first.
Well, Aaron and I have been married for 3 years. We have a 1-year-old boy named Noah. We moved here about a year ago when Aaron got a job in town, so we've been attending this church for almost a year.
So what about you? What types of things do you like to do?
I'm kind of an active person. Aaron and I love the outdoors. We enjoy water sports and camping. I love cooking and crafts. And I love kids. I grew up in a big family.
Some moms find children a little draining.
Yeah, I have my moments, but overall, I really enjoy working with young children. I occasionally watch some small kids in the neighborhood on a part-time basis. I plan activities for them in our house, and we have a lot of fun.
So tell me about you and your spiritual gifts, what you learned from the seminar.
Well, the assessment that I took told me that I had the gifts of craftsmanship and hospitality. I love working with my hands, and I like having people over.
What did you learn from the input you received from others?
I was surprised. Many people said to me, "Emily, you have the gift of evangelism. It's as plain as day." I always thought you had to go to seminary to be a preacher or evangelist, but when I have the neighbor's kids over, I really love to read them Bible stories. In fact, their mother is coming with me to Sabbath school next week. She wants her kids to learn more about God.
Sometimes we confuse a spiritual gift with a specific ministry position. Some people have a teaching gift, but that doesn't mean they have a professional degree in teaching. It sounds like God has given you the gift of sharing Jesus with children.
I hadn't thought about it like that, but I think you're right. So, how can I use my gifts at church?
What did you learn in the gifts and ministries exercise in the seminar?
The most obvious thing that jumped out at me was to help out at children's Sabbath school.
There's always a need in those departments, and I think we should explore that as an option. But I'd like you to think about more than one position, especially in the area of child evangelism.
You want me to take on more than one ministry?
No, I want you to explore more than one ministry and then choose the one that fits you. As a young mother, you have many responsibilities. I suggest you find one ministry in which to serve.
What are some other options?
Every summer, our church holds a vacation Bible school program for the children in the neighborhood. It's our biggest outreach to kids each year.
I love VBS. When I was a teenager, I used to help my mom back at our church at home.
This fall, we're also planning a series of evangelistic meetings. While the adults are in the church sanctuary, we will also have classes for the children.
Wow, I can help out in all three ministries.
I love your enthusiasm, Emily. But as a church leader who works with volunteers, I have 3 things I want to share with you.
What's that?
First, you need to take care of yourself and your family. Sometimes volunteers take on too much and neglect their own life.
Yeah, Aaron has mentioned that.
Second, we encourage volunteers to explore options and to find the right fit. So I'm going to give you the names of the leaders for 3 different ministries: Beginner Sabbath School, Vacation Bible School, and the woman who leads our children's evangelism program for the fall meetings. If it's all right with you, I'd also like to pass on your name to each of the leaders.
Sure, but how can I try them all out?
Oh, before you make any commitments, I want you to just talk with each one of them. You already attend Beginner Sabbath School with Noah, so you have a feel for that program. I'd like you to talk with each of these leaders and just see which one fits for you.
That sounds good.
You probably remember that all of our volunteers who work with children must go through the Shield the Vulnerable training and get a background check. It's all online, and the information is right here. It will get you all set up.
Oh yes, I'm so glad that this program is in place.
There's one more thing I want to share with you, Emily.
What's that?
Do you remember in the parable of the talents what happened to those who used their talents? God blessed them with greater opportunities for service.
What do you mean?
Some volunteers get in a rut. They find a place of service, but never really develop their talents. I want to encourage you to learn more about your gifts. Read a book, attend a seminar. I want you to expand your abilities.
I like to do that. Thanks for the suggestions.
So, it looks like Noah and your husband will be back anytime now, so we probably should wrap up. Do you have any questions for me at this point?
I do have one question. Do I contact these three leaders, or do they call me?
Thank you for asking. Because it's easy for people to miss each other, we ask both you and the leaders to reach out to one another. It'll just increase the likelihood of you all connecting. And if you have any problems, of course, please call me. Let me get you my card. Here's my number. So call me if you need anything. In about a week or so, I'll just check in with you to make sure everything's running smoothly.
I sure appreciate this time that we could talk. It's made things much clearer.
And I am just so grateful for your open heart to serve here in our church. I'm so excited to see how the Lord uses you.
Thank you.